Hello, I am Fiske. This is my YouTube channel where I will be dropping most of my content. Together we can do it. Thank you. Yeah, hello, my project is now set. So for my previous video, you will understand what has been done here. So right now, I'll be showing you how to use list in IText 7 onto our pages. So right now, the first thing I have to do right now, I have to call in a paragraph class to add my heading. So paragraph. So I'll name the variable be heading. The variable as heading. So in this my list, I want to name a list of programming languages. So I have to call the heading list of programming languages. So list of programming languages. So let me add a semicolon. So to add it onto my page, so I have to access the feed document. So that's now my heading is added onto the page. So let me set a font size to it. Dot set font size of 18. Font size of 18. So right now, to add a list, to add list in IText 7, there is a class called list. So we need to access the class. So I'll name an object right now. So list. So languages, I will name the list languages as the variable. So right now, this is the class to add a list in our pages. So anytime we want to add a list, we need to call in this class. We instantiate the class list. So right now, the list is not added onto the page. So to add list onto our page now, we need to do like this. Yeah, now to add the list onto our page, so we have to do it like this. Languages dot add. So the first language I want to add right now is C sharp as my first list. So C sharp. Let me copy this. So I'm adding my list just like this, as simple as this. So my second will be Java. So let me add JavaScript. Let me add Python. So add Ruby. So the last one, let me add PHP. So right now, I've made the list of programming languages. To now add the list onto my page, I have to call in the object variable for my list class. That is the languages. So first of all, to add, as usual, we have to call in the document. Document.add. So what I want to add right now is the languages. I have to add these languages onto my document to be shown on my page. So that is languages. So right now my list is added onto it. So that's how to add a list. So let me run the project first and let me see. So the PDF has been created. So let me head to my folder and check my PDF. So this is the list. Yeah, let me start up. Yeah, now this is my list of programming languages, C#, Java. So we can see the symbol of the list right now. I'm having a dash. You can also change the symbol. So let me go ahead and change the symbol and show you how to change the symbol in a list. So right now, to change the symbol in the list, I have to call in the object variable, that is the languages. So languages dot, that is add list symbol. Set list symbol, language dot set list symbol. So this is it. Set the list symbol to be used. So that now to use a dot symbol instead of the dash. So there's a Unicode for it. So I access the Unicode. So that is 2022. So right now my symbol is set like that. So let me run the project again and see. So my PDF has been created. So let me head to my folder and check again. So right now, before it was a dash, right now I'm having dots as my symbol. This is how to add symbol onto our list. Thanks. Thank you.